so that root 2 is irrational number. So assume root 2 is rational number. So if root 2 is rational number, this is in the form of root 2 equal to p by q form. So here p comma q are coprimes. Coprimes means there is no common factor. So change these two terms, q equal to p by root 2. Squaring on both sides. So then you will get q square equal to p by root 2 whole square. That means p square root 2 whole square equal to p square by square root cancel 2. So here 2 is divides p square and also divides p. Here 2 is divides p square and also be p. So let p equal to 2c. Now this is equation 1. From 1 q square equal to p square by 2 equal p means 2c whole square by 2 equal to 2 square 4 c square by 2. 2 is cancelling 2 times, so equal to 2c square. So 2 is multiplying here, go to here dividing. So q square by 2 equal to c square. So here 2 is divides q square and also divides q. Here 2 is divides q square and also divides q. So here 2 is divides also p and 2 is divides also q. So 2 is the common factor of p and q. Therefore 2 is common factor of both p and q. Therefore our assumption is wrong. Root 2 is not a rational number because coprime p comma q are coprimes, there are no common factors, but 2 is the common factor p and q. So our assumption is wrong. Therefore root is not a rational number. Therefore root 2 is irrational number. Root 2 is irrational number. Second question, show that root 5 is irrational number. So assume root 5 is rational number. So if root 5 is rational number, this is in the form of p by q. Here p comma q are coprimes. So p comma q are coprimes. Then change these two terms, q equal to p by root 5. So squaring on both sides, then q square equal to p by root 5 whole square. That means p square root 5 whole square, so p square by 5. Here 5 is divides p square and also be p. So 5 is divides p square and also divides p. This is equation 1. Let p equal to 5c. From 1, q square equal to p square by 5. P square means 5c whole square by 5 equal 5 square means 25 c square by 5. 5 times cancel. So equal to 5 c square. So 5 is multiplying here, go to here, divides. So q square by 5 equal to c square. So here 5 is divides q square and also divides q. 5 is divides q square and also divides q. So what you observed in these two cases, 5 is the common factor. 5 is the common factor. Therefore, 5 is common factor of both P and Q. P and Q. Therefore, our assumption is wrong. Our assumption is wrong. Therefore, root 5 is not a rational number. So therefore root 5 is irrational number. Next, third one, show that 5 minus root 3 is irrational number. So assume 5 minus root 3 is rational number. So if this is rational number, this is in the form of P by Q. P comma Q are integers. So 3 this side. So 5 minus P by Q equal to minus root 3, go to here, plus root 3. LCM 5q minus p by q equal to root 3. Here p comma q are, integers. So 5q minus p by q is rational number. So this is rational number, then what about this? Root 3 is also be rational number. Therefore, root 3 is rational number. But root 3 not a rational number. Root 3 is irrational number. So our assumption is wrong. Therefore 5 minus root 3 is irrational number. So this is the solution of 5 minus root 3 is irrational number. Next, fourth question, show that 6 plus root 2 is irrational number. So let us assume 6 plus root 2 is rational number. Then this is rational number, then this is in the form of P by Q. Here P comma Q are integers. So 6 is moved to this side, so root 2 equal to P by Q minus 6. So root 2 equal to P minus Q into 6, so 6Q by Q. So here P comma Q are integers. So P minus 6Q by Q is rational number. So if this is rational number, what about root 2? This is also be rational number because they are equal in sign. So therefore root 2 is rational number. But but root 2 is not a rational number. So our assumption is wrong. Our assumption is wrong. So 6 plus root 2 is irrational number. 6 plus root 2 is irrational number. Next, 5th question. Show that 3 plus root 5 is irrational number. Let's assume 3 plus 2 root 5 is rational number. So if this is rational number, what about this is in the form of p by q. 3 plus root 5 equal to p by q. Here p comma q are integers. So plus 3 here minus 3, 2 root 5 equal to p by q minus 3. So 2 root 5 equal to p, 3 into q, 3 q by q. 2 is multiplying here, go to here, divide. So root 5 equal to p minus 3 q by 2 q. So here p comma q are integers. So p minus 3 q by 2 q is rational number. So if this is rational number, what about root 5? This is also be rational number because of equivalent sign. Therefore root 5 is rational number. But root 5 is irrational number. So our assumption is wrong. Therefore 3 plus 2 root 5 is an irrational number. Now 6th question. Show that 1 by root 2 is irrational number. So solution, assume 1 by root 2 is rational number. So if this is rational number, this is in the form of p by q. Here p comma q are coprimes. Squaring on both sides, 1 by root 2 whole square equal to squaring on both sides, 1 by root 2 whole square equal to p by q whole square. Root 2 square 2 equal to p square by q square. So q square into 1, q square by 2 equal to p square. Here 2 divides q square and also divides q. So let q equal to 2c. This is the equation 1. From 1, what about 1? P square equal to q square by 2. Q means 2c whole square by 2. 2 square 4c square by 2. 2 4 2 times cancels. So 2c square. 2 is multiplying here with c. So go to here, dividing. P square by 2 equal to c square. So here 2 divides p square and also divides p. So what do you observe here? 2 is divides q and 2 is divides p. So 2 is the, therefore 2 is common. 2 is common factor of both Q and P. Q and P. Therefore, our assumption is wrong. So our assumption is wrong. Therefore, 1 by root 2 is irrational number. 1 by root 2 is an irrational number.